In 1887, Elizabeth Jane Cochran faked mental illness to observe and record one of the first cases of undercover investigative journalism in American history. She came to be known under the pen name Nellie Bly, which she received during her time writing at the Pittsburgh Dispatch. As one of the first female journalists in history, Bly grew tired of being constricted to only writing pieces for a female audience. She moved to New York City in pursuit of a job that would better fulfill her journalistic goals in the male-dominated industry. After nearly 6 months of searching for a job, Bly walked into Joseph Pulitzer's New York World in hopes of being given a chance. Pulitzer hired Bly on the spot, impressed by her ingenuity and radical ideas. Together, they devised a plan to try something that had never been done before. For her first assignment, Bly impersonated a madwoman and was admitted to Blackwell's Island Lunatic Asylum upon being declared a demented, hopeless case. During her 10 days at Blackwell's Island, she was exposed to the harsh reality present in mental institutions at the end of the 19th century. Some of her findings included cramped cells infested with rats, physical abuse of patients, and denial of food and water. She described the mental institution as a human rat trap that was easy to get in, but impossible to get out. Upon her release from the asylum, Bly went on to write a series of articles that were published in New York World, and later wrote a book called 10 Days in a Madhouse. These pieces detailed her horrific findings and included illustrations of all that she had observed. Bly's discoveries at the asylum caused public uproar and led to an investigation by grand jury. The investigation resulted in statewide reform of mental institutions, as well as an $850,000 budget increase for the Department of Public Charities and Corrections in the state of New York, thus beginning the age of investigative journalism. Following the monumental success of her expose on Blackwell's Island, Bly continued her career at New York World. 2 years later, in 1889, she was recognized as the first woman to travel the world in 72 days, breaking all previous records. Bly remained a prominent figure in the face of journalism, producing numerous investigations and exposures of social injustices. In the years to follow, many journalists adopted Bly's undercover investigative style to expose political corruption and the manipulation of big business. This era was deemed yellow journalism and fed into the establishment of the muckraker. Thanks to the courage and persistence of women like Nellie Bly, women have been empowered to succeed in the career of their choice.